Hai, selamat pagi dan selamat siang untuk kelas HA dan HB, ICT for HI atau TIK untuk Hubungan Internasional Universitas Budi Luhur. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat pagi, salam sejahtera untuk kita semua. Om Swastiastu, Salam Nama Budaya, Salam Kebajikan, dan Salam Budi Luhur. Rekan-rekan, kita langsung ke main course-nya aja, main course. Makanan intinya ya. What should we get in the Information, Communication, and Technology for International Relations? First of all, we could see last time in second lectures, we get like some of the examples about the regimes, global regimes to establish, to govern international trade, human rights, and those ICT to surveil its citizens and international organizations that established to overseas the ICTs not really have a concern or power to do so. Anyway, as a matter of fact, we can continue from the last time we met. Let me check first. I'm gonna see, yeah, pertemuan minggu kedua ini. Harusnya ya. Can see. Alright. Okay. Students can see this thing. Yeah. Last time we see a lot of notes here. Mainly about ICTs, internets, transferable technologies, every single white dot in the world map you see today is a node, is a server to serve information network all around the world 24/7, 24 hours, 7 days a week. You could imagine. That's a lot of information that's going around us. Last time we called about World Wide Web, about the percentage of internet use since 2011. Global regimes, the fact Snyder says like about, oh, these things I never told you guys. Any organized crime syndicate with enough money to launch a large-scale attack against the financial system will do well to find a country with poor computer crime laws, easily bribable police officers. Seems like I know which country they talking. Maybe us? Maybe yes, maybe no. And no extradition treaties. Oh, it's really Indonesian? Thanks. Advancements in communication technology poses fundamental challenge to conventional diplomacy such as reducing hierarchy. I told you about a lot of layoff inside the Ministry of Foreign Relations and breaching confidentiality. Hey guys, you have an Instagram, you have a TikTok, you have a Facebook, you have a, last time you have a Google Plus, now Google Plus is not really access anymore. We have WhatsApp, we have Telegram, we have all kinds of the social media. And matter of fact, how could a debt collector, how could the e-commerce, Bukalapak, Tokopedia, Shopee, Lazada, heck, even Alibaba, Gojek, Grab, could have your ID and exact location? Where do you stand? Where do you play at? What kind of goods, barang apa yang kamu beli setiap hari atau setidaknya dalam jangka waktu sebulan? They have your confidentiality, your bank account, your license ID. Your father and your mother name, your sister and your friend, phone book. Very transparent. You are naked in terms of identity. Everybody knows. I want to know about Andrea Abdurrahman, the lecturer of IR in Budi Luhur University. Just type in, or just pop up link and pop up Instagram. It's pop up in the web, in the newspaper, this and that. You can search me. You just can search around using keyword, Google keyword, Yahoo keyword, Bing keyword, this and that. There's a multi-directional debate and influence mobilizing global social movement. Nowadays, people tend to stick around to the desk and the chair displays. What? Mabar, we say. You play online games, whichever I don't want to state so much. Anyway, in the term of these things, Frederick point out, throughout history, one clear pattern is apparent. Every time a new innovation in communication technology appears, sooner or later, international law arises to regulate it. In the past, zaman dulu, ketika internet ada, nggak segitunya tuh, ada blasphemy itu bid'ah. Kalau ngomong agama yang bid'ah, ada nabi, atau ada rasul, atau ada Tuhan, atau ada apapun itu yang agama, dicela-cela, dicaci-caci, direndahkan. Dulu belum ada, tiba-tiba ada ITE law, Information Electronic Transaction and Information Law in Indonesia. Blasphemy is not in the term. Jadi bid'ah atau heresy ya, itu nggak masuk dalam terminologinya di Undang-Undang ITE. Tapi menjelek-jelekkan yang membuat orang tersinggung, membuat kerusuhan, dan dirasa negatif, itu bisa kena hukuman. Misalnya nih, saya nggak pakai contoh orang lain, saya nggak pakai contoh anak presiden, contohnya saya aja. Pak Andre kelihatannya dongok banget ya. Misalnya, nggak usah ketawa, tapi ada yang ngomong gitu kan. Sotoy banget tuh dosennya. Ya kan, kesannya kayak dia paling tahu, ngalang-ngalang Einstein aja. Saya nggak suka. Saya lapor ke polisi, saya screen cap. Di WAG, WhatsApp group. Oh, dia ngomong juga di video. Dia taruh di Facebook. Saya capture, saya laporkan ke kepolisian, ke cyber, divisi cyber. Those person will be tracked down and my report is verified. If it's verified, is it true? Those person could get 2 years in jail. Dia kena hukuman 2 tahun cuma gara-gara tangannya nggak sekolah, otaknya ngawang, matanya jelalatan. Terus masalahnya kenapa ngawang? Nggak dipikirin dulu. International rules itu sekarang mirip undang-undang ITE kita. There's another thing. That's internal. For the external, this for IR. In November 2000, for example, it's like 2 decades ago, 2 dekade yang lampau, 20 tahun yang lalu. A network was cracked that involved the use of internet by criminals in China and Republic of China. In China is mainland China, Republic of China is Taiwan. To illicitly siphon off money from South African bank, such successful police action must be the result from extensive cooperation between the security agencies from both sides of the Taiwan Strait. This China, the Communist China, and this China, the Republican China. Yet the government do not even talk each other. These two countries, in the police term, not the government, in IR we see, interdepartment in foreign country could have relations, but in any case, the government don't have any relation, diplomatic ties, ikatan diplomasi. Gara-gara apa? Ada kelompok penjahat di mainland China, di Cina daratan dan Cina pulau Taiwan itu sindikat maling uang pakai internet banknya Afrika Selatan. Polisinya kerjasama buat nangkepin orang-orang tadi. Permintaannya dari bank Afrika Selatan. So the analogy of IT, IR, and globalization. This is the last subject we could brought up. I want to turn it will be 10 minutes, so we just have a quick grasp about the things. The challenge that that such international cooperation present liberal democracy have become clearer since the terrorist attack that took place against New York and Washington on September 11, 2001, when leaders of the states that make up of Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation Forum, APEC, issued a statement on counter-terrorism at Shanghai on 21st October. In the same year, for instance, they called for measures to counter all forms of terrorist attack. What this things means? Is this things means that all other critical sectors, especially IT, is inside the strengthening activities to subdue. Jadi apapun yang terjadi di ranah IT, sekarang ada blockchain, sekarang ada reksadana, sekarang ada transfer uang antar negara, sekarang ada bahkan sekarang orang anak-anak muda kayak kalian bisa mengakses deep web. Deep web itu apa sih? Sebenarnya deep web itu jaringan internet yang kebanyakan digunakan oleh bukan penjahat tapi tidak ada regulasinya. Jadi apapun yang digunakan sama kalian pakai browser Chrome, Safari, apalagi DuckDuckGo dan lain sebagainya, Explorer mungkin, atau Microsoft dipakai Blend, I think. Edge, gantinya Microsoft Explorer. Itu semuanya aksesnya tuh normatif. Ini nggak normal, kenapa dia pakai browser khusus untuk akses situs-situs yang emang nggak dipublish. Harus pakai browser khusus, itu namanya deep web. Itu di semua ranahnya di IT. So, enhance border security, strengthening capacity building, and economic technical cooperation. Member economies into place and force. Nggak usah counter terrorism dulu. Jadi, this term is used by ICTs in any countries around APEC, Asia Pacific Economic Community. China, US, Australia, Brunei, Canada, Chile, Hong Kong, Indonesia, Japan, Malaysia, Mexico, New Zealand, Papua New Guinea, Peru, Philippines, Russia, Singapore, South Korea, Taiwan, Thailand, and Vietnam. This APEC country says that all about these things, enhance border security. What kind of border? IT border. Ladies and gentlemen, now we're facing 21st century problems, IT or ICTs. In terms of IR, in next meeting, the next meeting, in next video, I will brought you new perspective. What kind of border in term of ICT in international relation between countries? Jadi batasan apa, perbatasan seperti apa di dunia maya yang dimiliki oleh masing-masing negara? Karena nggak ada sebenarnya. Yang jadi bordernya apa? Aturan kawan-kawan. Saya kira sampai di sini dulu. Terlalu banyak pertanyaan nantinya kalian. Sekarang kalian bisa nikmatin lihat YouTube. Kalau masih kurang, Pak, nih apa ya Pak Andre ngomong kenapa? Bisa diulang. Silakan chat di WhatsApp group. Tadi yang chat saya itu si Laura ya. Thank you Laura, udah kasih notion. Ini juga baru saya up tadi buat kewarganegaraan. Sekarang tadi Laura kewarganegaraan, sekarang untuk ICT. Tapi in terms kayak same class, you guys said 2019, 2020. So meet you guys in next videos, in its next sessions. Hope you guys are more healthy. Going everywhere, use mask. Invitation to have a vaccines, please do so, and please selalu ikuti prokes. We'll get back to you soon. Wabil taufiq wa hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera. Salam budi luhur. See you guys around. Bye-bye.